So all of you visible screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's visible.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's okay.
So welcome you all for today's webinar session hosted by Department of Mechanical Engineering, Dr. T. Timmaya, Institute of Technology, KGF. Let me introduce you a resource person for today's session, Dr. N. Mohan, sir, who is heading Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, Dr. Ambedkar Institute of Technology. So we welcome you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Professor and Head Department of Mechanical Engineering, Dr. T. Timmaya Institute of Technology.
We would also, like to we would like to thank you for accepting our invitation even on your busy schedule, sir.
Sir, no, thank you, sir. It is no issue. Sorry for the inconvenience. The program is rescheduled. So instead of this 18th, it is the program 5 to 6 o'clock. Due to some emergency meeting with my higher authority and some related to tech peoples, due to these reasons, my sincere apology for rescheduling of these programs to 2 days to 3 p.m. So anyway, I thanks to give an opportunity for this Dr. Timmaya Institute of Technology principal management. And head of the department of department of mechanical engineering, Dr. T. Timmaya Institute of Technology, and also some special interest taken for this organizing this program, Dr. Manjunath Babu, is also I thanks for given opportunity. It's my immense pleasure to talk about webinar program on basic concepts of polymer composites manufacturing processing and its applications.
Now I request our HOD Dr. HG Shenoy sir to introduce a resource person and address the session gathering. Sir, over to you, sir.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, all the students, and good afternoon, all the faculty members who are present over here. So it gives me immense pleasure to give this the welcome address. So on behalf of management of GVET and Timmaya Institute of Technology, and principal, staff, and all students, I welcome Dr. N. Mohan to this webinar, sir. I welcome you, sir. And thank welcome you, sir. All the faculty members who are present here and all the students who are present here to be very interactive, to ask some questions, and all the knowledge sharing has to be done properly. So this is my request. So the topic today is very nice, very basic, even though it is looks like basic, but it is very essential for the today's researchers, for today's researchers who are doing the research. So the basic concept of composites.
Very good.
The basic concept of, please others, please put on mute. The basic concepts of polymer composites manufacturing processes and its applications. So it is a wonderful topic, and we have with us for today Dr. N. Mohan, and is a professor, Department of Industrial Engineering and Management, Dr. AIT Bangalore. And I have gone through his resume; it's a huge one. So after concising, we have a few highlights I need to tell about him. He has pursued his UG and PG from UVC Bengaluru, and he has done his PhD from NIT Tiruchinappalli. And he is having 7 years of industrial experience and 18 years of teaching experience. Very vast experience he's having. He has published more than 60 papers in reputed journals. That all the journal papers we have seen, it is all very reputed journals. And also he has written, I think, a book. On e-book also he has written, very nice, sir. And also he is a member of various professional bodies. He is a reviewer of various journals, and he has received 2 awards for his best technical papers. And he is a faculty advisor for team Nakshatra Go-Kart Light Cars, and he has made contributions as DCS Board of Education and in tech coordinator also. He has guided more than 4 PhD candidates, and his research publication citations are more than 500. This is a small brief introduction to such a big man. So I welcome once again, sir. So I thank you once again for having accepted our invitation and to come over here. Thank you, sir. Please continue.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot, sir. So I will proceed, sir. Thanks a lot.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
So today's webinar program is on basic concepts of polymer composites manufacturing, processing, and its applications. So the word composites, the word polymer, the word manufacturing, processing, and its applications. So generally, people's know the materials. What is the basics? Basic materials. It starts from scratch from our sand, rock, and some constructions equipment. So mixing of generally people know mixing of one materials with another materials, it is called as the composite materials. Generally in the wood, we can possible for composite materials. So the pasting one materials with the another materials, it is called as the polymers. So generally any paste, any epoxy, any resin or any fevicol is pasted one materials with the another material, so to get a product, it is called as the composite. It is called as the polymer composites. But it is the some basic fundamentals. So generally in the plywood board, cardboard sheets, and also some laminated board. So these are all comes under the classifications of the composite materials. So the major is polymer. So the polymer is a thermoplastic polymers or thermosetting polymers. It is the major. It is the major constituents of the composites materials. It is reinforced with one materials with the another materials. So this is the general concept. You know the general basics in day to day life. We are using the materials composite materials, but the same materials it goes to the different use applications and in the sophisticated products. We can possible for manufacturing the sophisticated product in aerospace, defense, naval board, naval, and also in the space applications. So the manufacturing concepts of the composites is different, and the processing is also different depending upon the applications. So come back to the drive shaft for JV pickup truck. It's made up of a steel. So you know, say the there's a connecting shaft. It is connected from engine to rear wheel. So there is a steel materials is using, and also some kinds of alloy materials is also using. So we want to reduction of weight. So this is replacing with a drive shaft made up of a composite materials. We'll say weight. Say is it a carbon fiber or it is a glass fiber? Or it is a Kevlar fiber. So which one is the lowest price and highest can withstand the highest strength? That is the very good materials and low cost materials, and also the weight saving is also very important. And including saving of a weight, saving of the weight. So how much the materials will taking the load and thrust is also one of the very important. So this is the one of the Nissan car. So used with a Nissan car 350Z. So previously it is used in the some kinds of materials. It is called as the alloy materials. So now it is replaced with the carbon fiber materials. It is a polyurethane PU foam. It is reinforced. It is rolled with some kind of a polyurethane foam. And it, and this materials is connected in between the engine to rear wheel axle. So it will takes the more thrust, more load as compared to alloy materials. And also this materials, it is withstands the more load and more materials, and also weight saving. So a lot of weight saving. So why composite materials? The composite materials, it is one of the very important concepts of the composite materials is reduces its energy consumption, increases the amount of power transmitted to the wheels. About 70 to 22% of engine power is lost rotating the mass to the mass of the drive. And also this the composite materials is durable in life, fatigue resistant, and also the very important thing is a non-corrosive. It is a reduced maintenance cost and increase the life. Due to environmentally, materials will not take place any corrosion. So once it is a material is corrosion taking place, the materials will become, so we want to replace the materials every time. So it is made up of a single piece at a time. So there is no need to parts by parts manufacturing. It reduces the manufacturing cost also by using composite materials. So what is the composite materials? Is the definitions of the composite materials. A material is composed of a two or more constituents. It's a reinforcement base. It's called as the fiber, and binder. It is called as the component. It is called as the matrix. Fiber is one which is combined with the matrix materials in order to create a useful structure. Say simple example, it is the gravel, stone, sand, sand, stone and cement. It's a mixture. Say to get a useful composite structure. So it is useful construction structure. Similarly, in this composite materials, the fibers. You say the fiber is a metallic fibers or a glass fibers or aramid fiber or natural fibers. You have a sisal fibers, bamboo fiber, silk fibers or cotton fibers. So these are all fibers. This materials is pasted, one material with the fence pasted. Say example, bread is sandwiched. The bread is laminated by using a bread with a jam and heat the materials. You get some kinds of a sandwich materials. So like that, in this composite is also transfers to the fibers. So the matrix is one. It binds the fibers ends together, and also it transfers to the fibers, loads, and also protects the fiber from the damage. It is just like an envelope matrix. It's actually the envelope. So this is called as the matrix. It's a polymer matrix. The polymers plays very important role in the composite materials. It binds the fibers together and transfers to the fibers, loads, and also protects the fiber from the damage. So it is becomes a high strength and stiffness composite materials with a low weight ratio. Material can be designed in addition to the structures, can manufacture structures and eliminate the joints. So no need of a joint. A single component is manufactured by using a composite materials. A composite in nature is a oblong shell calcium carbonate. It's a mixture of one or two materials. It's called as the composite materials. 3% organic and greater than 3000 strong than calciate. This is the scanning electron microscope image of this composite oblong shell. So wood, it is also made up of a natural composite materials. It's cellulose filaments in a matrix of a lignin and hemicellulose growth of rings from layered composites perpendicular to the growth rings are readily oriented ribbon like structures raised, which provide a radial stiffness and reinforcement materials. The component of the composite materials is reinforcement fiber is glass, carbon, organic, boron and ceramic materials. These are all the fibers are reinforced from the fibers. It's a glass is a silica. It is a major constituent of the glass is a silica. And carbon, it is from a coal tar or some kinds of a carbon type of a material, some sort of a graphite materials. It is obtained from the some kinds of a treatment, some kinds of a manufacturing of a of organic compound and organic boron and ceramic materials and metallic fibers. Matrix materials, polymers is one of the important matrix materials. It is like a thermosetting plastic and thermoplastics materials. And also interface is also bonding surfaces. So resin, it is a hardener and resin. There is a two materials are given in the manufacturing or in the pasting of a one materials with another materials. It is the bonding materials. Suppose is the resin and hardener. So resin is some percentage and hardener is mixing with some percentage. So these two things are mixed. You are getting some kinds of a polymer type of a resin. This is mixed with some other kind of material to get a bond between the two materials to get a single product. Classifications of composite materials according to base matrix materials, metal matrix, ceramic matrix, polymer matrix, composites. So these are all depending upon the applications of use and also depending upon the temperature to which the materials plays an important role, where exactly the materials is applicable and where exactly materials is fits, where exactly which component it is used. Particular applications, the materials is selections is very, very important. So for continuous operations of the temperature, polymer is operating only for the 400 degrees Celsius and metal aluminium it is used to operating only for 580 degrees Celsius and ceramic it is used for 1000 degrees Celsius. Metal matrix composites include mixture of ceramics and metals such as the cemented carbides and other cements as well as aluminium or magnesium or titanium reinforced by strong high stiffness fibers called graphite, boron, alumina, silicon carbide and tungsten carbide. So these are all the materials, say metal matrix composites. In this includes mixture of ceramics and metals such as cemented carbides and other cements. These are all used in the high applications in the tool. Generally it is used in the cutting tool metals, cemented carbides, ceramics. These are all the materials, and also magnesium or titanium is reinforced strong high stiffness fibers called graphite, boron, alumina, silicon carbide and tungsten carbide. So generally processing of a polymer matrix composites, there is a different processing. One is solid state of fabrication, another one is a liquid state of fabrication. So the solid state of fabrication is a diffusion bonding, heating the materials and applying the pressure the two laminates. You are getting the bonding the materials. It is called as the diffusion bonding. And by using a powder metallurgy techniques, powder, say high compaction of the powders materials is compacted in the die and sintering, and also heated the materials to get some kinds of desired shape of the product is obtained by using a powder type of a metallurgy, and also extrusion. So another liquid state of fabrication, infiltrations on plasma by means of applying the pressure to get a product, and also skews casting, liquid state processing, casting, say wetting, chemical reaction, non-uniform mixing. These are the difficulties you can find in this liquid state of fabrications can be improved by using a pre-coating on reinforcement. Example, pyrolytic graphite coating, modifying the melt. Example, lithium and aluminium melt, compo casting, roasting, rio casting, infiltration on plasma, skews casting, deposition technique, chemical vapor deposition, spare deposition. These are all the processing of a metal matrix composites. This is the silicon carbide with aluminium. It's a hot molded silicon carbide aluminium materials. It is showing in this picture. Say aluminium 6061 and density is in most of the using aircraft materials is using aluminium 6061. So in addition to the flat panels, metal matrix composites can be fabricated into the neck shape cylinders, say beams, channels, and also other complex shapes can also possible. So this is applications of a metal matrix composites, high strength, low weight. It's a engine components. It is a form of high temperature, make a metal matrix composite. The material of a choice for gas turbine engine component. It is manufactured by using a metal matrix composite. It is working in the high temperature applications. See, these applications of a metal matrix composites is a national aerospace plane, say manufacturing, say Rockwell, MC, Donald, Douglas, and Rocketdyne is a manufacturer. These are all the general dynamics. Component is structural components and benefits of weight savings and higher operating temperatures can possible for these materials. And also advanced flights, say this is the MC Donald Ducks. Say all aircraft fuselage, the entire body of the aircraft is manufacturing of a by using some of the metal matrix nose landing gear. Some solid type of a materials is manufactured by using a metal matrix composites. So benefits is life cycle, cost savings and weight savings is also one of the very huge advantages. And in the gas turbine engine, metal matrix composite is used in the exhaust nozzle, links, vanes and blades and case shafts and rings. So weight savings, higher operating temperatures can possible for operating this is the metal matrix composite. Because of this is the metal matrix composite, this is a upraised metal matrix up to 580 degree Celsius can possible. But if you go to above the 580 degree Celsius, you go to ceramic composites. So applications of this is the advantages is higher specific strength, elastic properties, service temperature is more, and the materials metal matrix is insensitive to moisture, higher electrical and thermal conductivity, better wear resistance, fatigue resistance is also, these are all the main advantages. And also it's the main advantages is it is operating above 600 degrees Celsius, generally it is used for the metal matrix composites. So general more applications of metal matrix composites is the fiber is carbon, silicon carbide and tungsten. It is used in the combustion chamber nozzle. So matrix is copper based materials and tubing. So tungsten, it is used for tubing and blades and disc. Alumina is used for alumina is mixed with reinforced with the matrix nickel based interlaminates, blades and disc. And also silicon carbide, titanium based interlaminates, housing tubings, blades, disc, shafts and honeycomb materials in the aircraft front. It is used for the radomes. And also alumina is used for the some of the portions in the fuselage of the aircraft and the fuselage structures. See in this right side of the diagram, there is one image. It is called as the fuselage structures of the some Boeing aircraft or some kinds of the aircraft materials. This is the structures, aluminium structures is made up of. Above this aluminium structures, there is a composite laminates is covered or enveloped in this structure, in these aluminium structures. Then by these aluminium structures, fuselage it is used for a light in weight. And it gives high strength and it is covered with a composite materials and wings, blades, structural members, and also directionally solidification, electricals, eutectates, and copper base, nickel base, and titanium base. These are all the materials that is used for the applications. And also cast special attachment fittings is also used for this metal matrix composite. There's some kinds of a fuel flow system and also fuel pipelines. These are all the manufactured in these aircraft structures and aircraft pipelines, aluminum matrix. So go to the above 600 degrees Celsius. Generally, it is using a ceramic matrix composites. List common composite matrix: aluminium oxide, silicon carbide are materials that can be embedded with their fibers. Carbon or silicon carbide for improved properties, especially in high temperature application and resistance to oxidations, in this ceramic matrix composites is used. The ceramic matrix composites materials are used to matrices includes alumina, boron carbide, boron nitride, silicon carbide, silicon nitride, titanium carbide. These are all the materials which withstands the high temperature. High temperature is nothing but alumina withstands about 300 to 400 some temperature. But compared to alumina, boron carbide, boron nitride, silicon carbide, these are all the materials which withstands the very very high temperature, and also it's the high stiffness, high hardness, hot hardness at high temperature, good compressive strength. So they are compared to this one, the low toughness, the disadvantages of these materials and susceptibility of to thermal cracking. So reinforcing ceramics with fiber such as a silicon carbide or carbon increases their fracture toughness and it can be operation for the extreme service temperature. This is the beauty of the ceramic matrix composites materials. So come back to the what is polymer matrix composites. There are two types of polymer. It withstands only 400 up to the 400 degree Celsius. Only a certain polymers it is used for up to 400 degree Celsius, but not all the polymer matrix not possible for more than 400 degree Celsius. Epoxy is one of the thermosetting polymers. It withstands up to a 160 and 170 degree Celsius, and phenolic materials it withstands about 300 degree Celsius. These are all thermosetting resins are the most widely used polymers in polymer matrix composites.
Sir, I have set
already auto admin, but it is not taking.
Oh, okay, sir. You can make me as a host, sir, so that I can control it.
Auto admin is not possible. Okay, no, it is okay. Yes, all the people are there. More than 23-4 people are there. No problem. So this is the polymer materials. The one of the polymer matrix. It is widely used in the structural applications also in the tiles, say you observed in the olden days temples, and some of the temples the granite is fixing one granite to another granite. There is a epoxy is bonding between the one edge to another edge. This is one of the epoxy materials is used in the civil constructions also. And also this epoxy is mixed in the casting also, in this casting in the sense green sand molding. In this green sand molding, there is some kinds of ingredients are used to mixture of this one. So there were mogase. This one, what is that? Some kinds of binders is used, including that binders. The epoxy is also one of the binders is used in the green sand molding also. And also epoxy is used for reinforcing one materials with the another materials. And also polyesters are commonly used reinforced by a thin diameter fibers of a glass, graphite, aramite, and boron type of a fibers materials. These are all the materials it is used depending upon the applications. So the glass is used one applications, general applications in the fibers, entire fuselage it is used for the glass fibers. And graphite it is also used somewhere it is in the aircraft, different parts of the aircraft. And also some portions from engine to cockpit sections, there is some kinds of aramide fibers. It is used with phenolic resins. And also aramide it is used for its highly corrosion resistant materials. This is aromatic hydrocarbon type of materials. There is some patent is there for these materials. Nobody is manufactured still. We don't know the what is the chemical structures and chemical formula for aramide material. We know the glass and graphite. Still the US patent is not released. What is this aramide? So and also boron. It is also one of the materials it is used for high temperature resistant materials. Matrix. What do you mean by matrix? Matrix, it is in advertisement you are observing. What is that in this fevical? This is called as the matrix. Joint materials is joining one materials with another materials by using a matrix. What is that matrix? It is called as the resin is and hardener. Resin is one. It is a mixing some portions of the one or two drops with the hardener with the resins. You are getting some kinds of a thick material. So the thick like a viscosity, thick liquid is obtaining. That material is coated in the somewhere. So automatically it is there is a gel time and part time is there. So there's a pot time is mixing the materials with a certain interval of time before the gel is started. After the gel it is started, you count the time. So when the materials is setting, before that gel, before that hardening the materials, you must apply the materials in the wherever the structure, whatever, where exactly manufacturing the composite materials. So the functions of the matrix is transmits the force between fibers. One materials with the another materials, there's a fibers, it is a force. So the entire fuselage, entire ribs in the aircraft materials, one force is, there's a vehicle is moving in the desert environment, there's a hitting a body, another body, there's a movement in which the force will be transmitted. It's a force, transmit the force between the one layer to another fiber and arrest the crack from spreading between fibers, and do not carry most of the load. Hold the fibers in proper orientation. If the matrix is not hold the fibers in the proper orientations, in that case, what happen? The fibers will become spreads in any directions. And it's, the next is the propagations of the crack will be propagations. And once the crack is propagations, so there is a materials will become a break down the matrix. So protect the fibers and also environment. And also matrix, it acts as a envelope. The matrix, it acts as a matrix, it acts as an envelope media. It protects the fiber from the environment. And also environment, and also it is not taking place the any corrosion. Corrosion is also product. It's a plastic type of materials. So mechanical force can cause cracks that allow environment to affect fibers, that not allow the environment. Demands on a matrix is intramural shear strength is a good toughness, moisture, environment resistance, and also temperature properties, and also cost is also very important in this matrix. So almost all we have to use the low cost and high strength and high durability matrix material. So generally we have using the materials, it is called as the general purpose, it is called as the epoxy. It is used in the bearing liners to aircraft and spacecraft applications. General epoxy for higher performance requirements such as in aerospace applications, epoxies are most commonly used materials. Epoxies have a reasonably high modulus and strength from the fast 20-25 years, the epoxy matrix used in the composite material research is going on continuously. This is the matrix is mixed with some other materials and going on the continuous research progress. Research is going on for this epoxy materials. Epoxy have a reasonably high modulus and high strength. Epoxies exhibit a low shrinkage and cure, good for adhesives. Epoxy service temperature up to 125 to 175 degrees Celsius. More than 175 degrees Celsius is not used. The glass transition temperature and some other DCS, differential scanning calorimeter, and TGA, thermal gravimetric analysis to check the service temperature of the epoxy material. Since available in more than 20 grades to meet the specific properties and processing requirement, low viscosity, low flow rate, which allow good wetting of fibers. The very important matrix is any matrix, it must be a good wetting of the fibers is very, very important, and prevent the misalignment of the fibers during the processing is also very important. If you apply any resin coatings on the any materials, there is no misalignment between the one fibers to another fiber is very, very important. It is nothing but is prevent the misalignment of the fibers during the processing. And also fiber must be a very it absorbs, it must be a good wetting property. The one of the beauty of the materials is epoxy is one of the very good materials. It provides the good wetting properties and good does not allow the misalignment of the fibers. The reinforcement phase is one dimensional and planar and random or three dimensional. So come back to what is the fibers. The orientations of the fibers is important in these polymer matrix composites and general composite materials. So the one dimensional, it is nothing but only one unidirectional. So that just it is called as the single. Maximum strength and stiffness are obtained in the directions of the fiber itself. It does not transmit the load in the multi direction. So it is in the form of a two dimensional woven fabric. It is called as the planar. Random or three dimensional composite materials tends to possess isotropic properties. It is called three dimensional x, y, and z. And two dimensional, it is called only for x and y direction. So how it looks like a fiber? Fiber is a viscous, is a materials, a fiber materials viscous. Thin single crystals as a large length to diameter ratio. Graphite, silicon nitride, silicon carbide fibers, high crystal perfections, extremely strong, strongest, known, very expensive material, fiber materials is also available. Fiber polycrystalline or amorphous, generally polymers or ceramic, carbon, aramide, e-glass and boron. These are all the general generally using up to today in India. It's using carbon, aramide and e-glass, the different applications. Classifications, compared to the different classifications of the glass fibers, there is a e-glass fibers, S-glass fibers, C-glass fiber, D-glass fibers and A-glass fibers. So what is meant by e-glass? E-glass, it stands for the electrical, as it was designed for electrical applications. It is called as the e-glass. So the glass fibers, it's a look like it's a extraction by using a glass. Silica is the major constituents of the materials, and S-glass, it stands for the higher content of a silica, and it retains its strength at a high temperature as compared to E-glass. And C-glass, it stands for the corrosion used in the chemical storage tanks, and D-glass, it stands for dielectric, used for the low electric dielectric radome and radome. You're saying in the aircraft front portion, it is called as the radome. It transmits the electromagnetic radiations from outside to inside the radar. So it covers the radar. It is called as the dome. It's a air glass fiber. Yes, A stands for the appearance. It is the improve the surface appearance. It is called as the air glass fibers. So graphite is the graphite fibers have a 93% to 95% of the carbon content produced at 1,360 degrees Celsius. Graphite fibers have a more than 99% of the carbon content produced at 1,900 degrees Celsius. These are all the materials how it looks. The carbon fiber is a blocking color. So next is aramide fibers. Aramide fiber is the aromatic organic compound made up of a carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. Still the US patent is not released, nobody is manufacturing aramide fiber, though nobody is doesn't know the how the manufacturing process of these Kevlar fibers. Kevlar 29 is used for the bulletproof vest, ropes and cables. Kevlar 49, it is used in the aircraft industries. Almost all, it is the engine component. It is made up of aramide. It's a high temperature resistant material. Is the carbon. It is in color, is a gold in color. Say if you one day I visit KGF, I will display all these materials. I will tell, what is the application you can possible for feel these materials, how it looks, what is carbon fiber, what is the laminates of the carbon fiber, what is the what is that aramide fibers, what is the glass fibers and all those things. Advantages and disadvantages: E-glass, S-glass. Advantage: high strength, low cost, low stiffness, short fatigue life, high temperature sensitivity. These are all the different disadvantages of the E-glass and S-glass. Carbon is a moderate in cost, is high strength and high stiffness. It is used in the different parts of the aircraft structures. High stiffness, high temperature applications, ceramic materials are used. So low strength and high cost. Aramide, it is used for the high strength, high tensile strength, high toughness, hygroscopic, less interfacial strength, degradation in sunlight. So reinforcing face, the embedded face is most commonly one of the following shapes: composite materials, particle reinforced, fiber reinforced, structural. Say particle reinforced, large particles are reinforced and dispersion strengthened. Fiber reinforced is called continuous aligned, discontinuous it is a short, and structural is called as the laminate and sandwich panels. So discontinuous is short is called as the aligned and randomly oriented. So this is the particle reinforced composite materials, disperse face, particles viscous. Random preferred orientation, isotropic and anisotropic. These are the structures. Now the particles are dispersed in the matrix materials, and particles viscous is a short fibers. It spreads inside the composite materials. It is called as the polymers. It is called as the epoxy matrix or any phenolic matrix. So these are all the fibers. So in this, what is the functions of matrix? It holds the fibers held together, and also it acts as the envelope and cover the fibers in the outside the environment. This is the tungsten carbide and cobalt cemented carbide metal matrix composite in the scanning electron microscope structures. So structural fibers, laminated sandwich panels. Say this is the honeycomb materials in between the two sheets, the face sheets, adhesive layer in between the two sheets, and honeycomb is one of the copper type of materials, is fabricated by using a sandwich materials. So this is the fiber alignment. So aligned and continuous, aligned and randomly discontinuous materials. So this is the one of the structure of the fibers in the matrix materials. So how does fibers are reinforcement in the work? See this one, stiff fibers strains less support matrix. See the, if you pull the materials in the composite material two directions, so the fiber is one, say surrounding the fibers there's a polymer matrix materials. See, this is fiber length, discontinuous versus continuous, loading direction, parallel versus perpendicular, orientation, aligned versus random. See these fibers, no? The polymer matrix is one which holds the fibers with the fibers together and transmits the force in the fiber itself. It protects the fiber from the damage. This is the very important functions of the matrix materials in the composite materials in the fiber reinforced composite. The fiber strength, they depend upon the different type of materials used in the different applications. So the strength of the specific strength of the materials is one, which is the E-glass, S-glass, Kevlar 49, Spectra, AS4 carbon, T300 carbon, CSIC, and the P100 carbon and boron. So the specific strength is the depending spectra on carbon is a very good specific strength as compared to E-glass, S-glass. And check this steel and aluminum. Very low strength as compared to E-glass, as compared to S-glass. As compared to spectra on Kevlar and carbon is the very good strength. This is the reason for carbon. It is used in the bumper of the automobile section. And also Kevlar. Inside the sea, these are all the materials is having a different strength and different models. So unidirectional composite material, see the unidirectional, is you apply the unidirectional composite material coordinate, x-axis and y-axis and z-axis. The basic element of a unidirectional composite is a thin sheet play materials. Axis are defined as follows: longitudinal direction parallel to fibers, transverse directions is perpendicular to fibers. See that the layers now is a cross, there is a one single lines, it is there in the composite matrix. It is called as the fibers. This is the longitudinal parallel to the fibers. See the longitudinal directions is the number one. It is a x-axis and y-axis and z-axis, y-axis, and this y-axis is called as the longitudinal direction. See in this longitudinal direction, that force is acts on the parallel to the fibers. And transverse is in the unidirectional composite matrix, it is perpendicular to the fibers. And z-axis is normal out of the plane. So this is the composite forces acting on the composite materials in the fiber reinforced composite materials. Modeling unidirectional composite behavior, fibers are assumed to be all the same, perhaps with a circular cross section and uniformly distributed throughout the matrix. The quantity of a fiber present is expressed as a fiber volume fraction. So even this is the unidirectional composites. If you take the bidirectional mean, there is a one more perpendicular to that line is passing one more fiber. So in that case, both longitudinal and transverse directions is not a perpendicular and parallel. It will be acting both multi-axis of the fibers. Multi-axis. Both two directions is acts in each unit of the composite materials. So the quantity of a fiber presents express fiber volume fraction. The matrix volume fractions is given Vm is equal to 1 minus Vf. It is called fiber volume fraction. Composite density can be calculated by density of the fiber and the volume fractions of the fiber plus density of the matrix plus volume of the matrix materials is calculated. You can get the directly, this is called as the rule of mixtures. You can take directly composite materials, density of the composite material. Transverse modulus 1 by E2 Vf divided by Ef plus Vm divided by Em. Shear modulus is 1 by G Vf divided by Gf plus 1 by Vm divided by Gm. Examples of the composite material density is calculated by this volume fractions is 0.7 and the matrix is 1 minus 0.7. Density of the materials is matrix is 1.2 to get the whole density of the composite materials. So longitudinal modulus is calculated by EC is equal to volume fractions and Young's modulus of the fiber and Young's modulus of the matrix and volume of the matrix. Volume of the matrix is and 1 minus 0.9. It is called as the volume of the fibers is also there. Let's say Vm is equal to 1 minus Vf or Vm is equal to 1 minus matrix density. This is EC is equal to 170 gigapascals. So say density of 1.2 grams per centimeter square. Modulus is equal to 3.12 and density is 1.77. Modulus is equal to 2 for carbon fibers. So the representative fiber properties, glass, E-glass, S-glass, carbon, AS4, aramide, Kevlar. Density is given in this ratio. So as compared to all the things, the carbon and Kevlar 1.44, is the Kevlar 29 is the least density of the density materials. And tensile modulus is highest tensile modulus you are observed in this boron fibers. So second highest is the 241, and you were observed in the carbon type of the carbon materials. This is called a tensile modulus. Tensile strength is very good tensor strength you are observing in this carbon fiber is one of the very good tensor strength materials as compared to carbon fiber. Glass is the one of the second most materials. The tensile properties is very good. Diameter of the materials is given in microns meter. Composite laminate, a useful structure will require that the fibers be oriented in more than one direction. A common approach to create a such a structure by stacking a layers or a place to perform. So laminate is placed, one is unidirectional, another is multi, one is a 45 degree, a 90 degree and a 0 degree. This is the orientation of the carbon, orientations of the place laminate. So depending upon the load, transmission of the load and structure of the composite materials is manufactured. See, the first top one is unidirectional, second one is a 45 degree, that line, no, straight line, and somehow it is a changes the straight line into a 45 degree, and again perpendicular to the 45 degree, it is nothing but 45 plus 45 degree and minus 45 degree, 0 degree and 90 degree. These are the play orientation. Depending upon the application, depending upon the strength of the composite material, we have orientations. The place of the composite materials is very important. So laminate stacking sequence definitions, the sequence of a place with a layer, play orientations are defined using a angle and also individual place are separated by a slashes 45 degree, 0 degree and minus 45 degree. In any aerospace industries, the laminates is manufactured, any fuselage structures, any composites materials. So by using a composite materials is a design orientations is a place or order top to bottom. It is in the from the z axis is the 0 degree, 90 degree, 45 degree, plus 45 degree, minus 45 degree. These are the total stacking sequences enclosed in the square brackets. Say symmetric with respect to middle surface, repeated in n times. Center layer uses the over bar in symmetric layer with the odd number of the place. So this is the stacking sequence of the composite materials. And the composite materials is not possible for manufacturing. In that composite materials, there is a cutting the play is 0 degree, is a one direction. And same the composite material 0 degrees are turned into some directions, it is called as the minus 30 degree. And again, it is opposite to the minus 30 degrees, say plus 30 degree. And again 0 degree and again minus 30 degree. Like that, it's 45 degree, plus 45 degree, plus 45 degree, plus 90 degree, 0 degree, 0 degree. This is the stacking sequence of the composite materials in any manufacturing of the composite materials. See, this is the stacking sequence of the composite materials. Composite structures manufacturing. Come back to the manufacturing engineering. An engineer must understand the capabilities and limitations of the manufacturing process to create the cost-effective designs, regardless of the materials to be used in order to design any composite structure. It is essential that the process to understanding is very important. Selection and process is depending upon the form of a material, the shape of the parts to be made. Some shape cannot be possible, some shape can be possible. The quantity to be produced, quantity, example, tolerances required, the allowable cost of the manufacturing is very important. Compared to the manufacturing of composite materials, hand lab, vacuum bagging, autoclave, compression molding, and liquid resin molding, pultrusion, filament winding, injection molding, thermoplastic processing, automated tape laying. See some of the evolutions of the manufacturing of the composite materials from hand lab to automated tape. So automated tape laying by using a robotics technology is introduced in this composite manufacturing. So come back to olden days, some 20-25 years back, by using a hand lab technique only they matter. By using a hand lab technique, layer by layer manufacturing of the composite, layer by layer placed on the die. So you are getting the after curing the materials, you are getting a solid part. After some time, by using a vacuum bagging technique, after that by heat the materials, instead of after vacuum bagging, after hand lab technique, we'll go to the heating treatment. By in the same heating and manufacturing, same it is called compression, hot compression molding machine, and liquid resin molding, and also pultrusion and the filament winding, injection molding. These are all the important aspects of the manufacturing process, different types of manufacturing process. Come back to the sand lab technique, it's called as the wet lab system. Wet lab is the simplest and most widely used process. Layers of dry fabrics are placed on a mold, one layer by another layer. So advantage is large parts can be manufactured. In the wind turbine blades, I think you know the Vascote, there is a LM wind turbine blades company is there. So it's a manufacturing of a very huge, I think more than 100 meters or 200 meters of the wind blades are manufactured. Is one single setup. It is used for the glass fiber is the one of the materials is used for the wind turbine blades, and also structures is also manufactured by using a glass fibers composite materials in the seashore and in the hill stations. This is the blades are rotating. It is manufactured by using a glass fiber techniques. So this is the one of the technique it is used for the glass fiber. First, it is the clean the mold by applying the releasing agent. Why the releasing agent is in the tawa, the preparations of the dosa. So dosa heat too. So it is nothing but dosa particles is not stick on the surface of the tawa. They are applying some kinds of the releasing agent. It is called as the oil before that. So after that, they are putting the dosa in the tawa. So like that, here also it is prepare the some kinds of a releasing agent is applied in this die. This is called as the boat is manufactured boat die. So this is a masterpiece is manufactured from by using a plaster of Paris die or a wooden die. After that, one part is manufactured by using a one masterpiece. Say female part, they are producing a number of male component to the production. So this is called as the layer by drying. Dry fabrics are placed on the on a mold, and resin is brushed or sprayed on it. So this is the manufacturing process. Layer by layer glass fabrics is a low cost tool. Pre-preg layer. The pre-preg is nothing but there is no any epoxy or any matrix materials is coated on the one layer to another layer. Here it is there's a pre-impregnated layer. It is a resin and is a required quantity and exact proportions of the resin is applied. It's already prepared in the complete. Just place the composite materials in the die. After that, it is cured in by using a autoclave. It is called as the pre-preg. It's called as the pre-impregnated resin. So I'm checking my battery condition. Sorry, pre-impregnated fibers. This is the pre-impregnated fibers materials. Fiber can be unidirectional or bidirectional. So in this image, you are observing there's a carbon fiber, so pre-impregnated carbon fiber. This is the company itself applied the required quantity of the exact required quantity of the matrix materials on the fibers itself. It is obtained in the form of a cellophane. It is obtained in the form of a tape. Say our this one, no, what is that? The tape means this kind of a tape. Say this is the pre-impregnated. Say this is the tape. The tape above this one is removed one layer. So this is the removed one layer, and directly you are getting a you are getting the this is the fabric materials. So this fabric materials one layer, another layer, another layer, another layer. After that, apply the vacuum bagging. So and then cured by means of an autoclave. Any composite materials it is cured, then only you are getting the desired properties of the composite materials. So advantages is the higher fiber volume fractions. Unidirectional materials not possible with a wet layer system. Say uniform fiber distributions, higher the quality, simplified manufacturing. So as compared to no need of operators or the manufacturer in the labors, no need of applying the taking the resin and coating in the fabrics layer by layer. Just to place the layer by layer and then do the vacuum sucking, remove the extra any excess resins in the materials, and then kept it in the autoclave, cure the materials, you are getting the solid component. So disadvantages is labor intensive, so like a wet lab, more expensive curing equipment is required. Added cost of a pre-preg is very costly as compared to the without pre-preg materials. Thermoset pre-pregs have limited shelf life. So vacuum bag molding. So all of you have some curiosity about what is vacuum bag molding. So vacuum bag molding is nothing but say just you. This is the bottom surface. It is called as the tool surface. So above the tool surface, you clean the tool and a mold and apply the this one. What is that? It's called releasing agent. First, you apply the releasing agent, and then you place the fibers, any fibers. You place the fibers, layer by layer fibers. First, you apply the one layer. So if it is prepreg means there is no need to apply the resin is coated on the layers, any glass fibers or carbon fibers or Kevlar fibers. You place on the mold, and then you apply the, by using a brush, you apply the coat the resin on the surface of the fiber. And again, you place one more layer and again coat. Like that, how many layers, depending upon the strength of the materials, you prepare the thickness of the composite material. So there is a layer, it is less than 0.3 mm. Say if you multiply it by 0.3 into 10 layers, you are getting the 3 mm thickness of the composites you are getting. So after that, there's a layer by layer composite is applied, the coated, and then the laminate is a peel play or a preformed releasing agent, releasing film is applied on the surface. That is called as a, there's a thermofilm, so plastic cover type of a material sheet is placed above the surface. And this is the vacuum hose or a vacuum connector is connected, is the one layer. And before that vacuum connector, vacuum hose fixed. After that, you seal the material's entire portion. So just general sealant like this in the tape, entire tape. There's a leak proof tape is applied, general sealant entire portion. And then by using a vacuum hose, you apply the one bar pressure. So to entire bag is sucked, the entire bag is sucked and removes the excess air present in between the surface. There is a, between the two surfaces, there is a air is stuck. In that, air is also removed and excess resin is also come outside. It comes outside the laminate. It spreads outside the laminate. There is a thick laminate without any air or without any extra resins present in between the two layers. After that, the entire portion is placed inside the autoclave and cure the material. So this is the vacuum bagging material. This is the vacuum pump to remove the excess resins present inside the material. There's the simplest form of the composite materials is obtained in the aerodynamic shape of the composite material. This is the autoclave processing. An autoclave is a pressure vessel that permits application of a high pressure than the vacuum bag molding. This is the layup and a bag. In the presence of a nitrogen atmosphere, the materials is cured inside the system. So this is the autoclave system. So the NL is having an autoclave system, and also LCA pods are all the things are. This is a computerized controlled autoclave. There is a, your entire pod is inside with the vacuum in the same pressure is applied on the surface of the composite materials and curing cycle. There is a 0 degree for different times, 100 minutes. 100 minutes, 200 minutes, and 300 minutes is a curing cycle. You check, there's a 50 minutes is a curing, there's an increasing the temperature from 30 degrees Celsius to 120 degrees Celsius, and maintain the 120 degrees Celsius from 50 minutes to 100 minutes. And again, 100 minutes to 120 minutes is increasing the temperature from 120 to 170 degrees Celsius, up to 170 degrees Celsius from 120 minutes to 240 or 270 280 minutes is a constant temperature is maintained. After that, drop down the temperatures, you are getting the solid composite block or a solid composite material. So it is made, you take a bread, two bread as a layer, soft layer, you apply the jam, you check the strength of the materials by hand, you feel. So for the same materials, you press it on the cure it in the microwave oven. After that, you remove the materials, you check the strength of the materials. Somehow that is increases the materials. The any composite materials, the strength of the composite materials is increased. Cure the materials at the desired temperature. So the desired temperature is depending upon the glass transition temperature of the matrix materials. So how you are using the matrix materials? There is a different types of thermosetting matrix materials. The one is a 120, the one is the epoxy materials, it's a 170 degrees Celsius, and the another materials is the phenolic, it can withstand more than 270 to 300 degrees Celsius. So some of the materials is used in the engine cowling applications and engine side application, engine turbine blades, covering applications and engine cowling and engine supporting, and some of the materials is used for the bearing liners applications. Thermal, different thermal properties of the these materials can possible for using different temperature. This is based on this your selections of the polymer matrix materials, and then it is cured in a different cycle time. So filament winding. Filament winding warps a continuous reinforcement of the resin impregnated fibers onto mandrel. So this is the one of the, there's a resin, fiber is passing in the resin bath, and then it is a combination of the mandrel rotation and the axial motion of the fiber source produces a helical flat form. You are getting the some kinds of a cylindrical section. After that mandrel is removed by using a some other kinds of applications. So filament winding, it is one of the, it is a pullers, curing die and FIFAMA, and then fiber rowing. So from the fiber rowing, it is a resin impregnated tank, the wet the fibers and the FIFAMA die and curing die and puller rolling. This is the filament winding process. And as the filament winding, is a pressure tanks, continuous filaments wounds onto the mandrel. So this is the helical winding. It is one of the circumferential winding and polar winding materials. So filament winding advantages is automated process, low labor cost, capable of making a large parts. And the disadvantages is limited to weight content may be high without the use of an autoclave. So in a winding thick parts, the process may have to be stopped to allow partial cure of initial layers, as the pressure of additional layers may squeeze out of resins. So this is the filament winding products. They can be used in the tanks, sea glass, highly corrosion resistant fibers are used for the resistance to chemical reactions. It is used in the chemical tanks, and also some of the chimney portions. It is also used in the filament winded product. So Delta for rocket fairing mandrel, it is also used for by using a filament winding process. And also resin transfer molding. So resin is a transferred in the layer, say bottom mold, there is a layer by layer dry reinforcement is there. There is a resin is transferred from the one side to another side. There is a layer is totally wetted and then remove the all the system and then heated in the autoclave system. This is called as the resin system. Somehow it is a sophisticated manufacturing at present. There is a sensors are fixed in the entire molding system. Once the resin is wet, automatically sensor is senses and stops the flow of the resin. This is one of the technique is used in the HAL and National Aerospace Laboratory and LM Wind Fibers Turbine Limited and also Tata Advanced Materials in the Jigni. And now it is a LM Wind Fibers in the Waskota. It is shifted to Tumkur industrial area. It's a GE turbine blades company. Now it is shifted to, instead of LM Glass Fibers changes its name to GE Sandover. General Electric is Sandover, this company. It is very near to Katsandra in the Tumkur. I think some kind of industrial Katsandra industrial area in the Tumkur. So the company is located. So what is that company name? Navagidwala LM Wind Fibers. ಯಾವ ತುಮಕೂರು ದವಾಸ್ಪೇಟೆ. ಸೊ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಮ್ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ರೆಸಿನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫೋರ್ ಮೋಡಿಂಗ್, ರೆಸಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೈರಲ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ರೆಸಿನ್ ಫೀಡ್ ಲೈನ್, ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಮ್ ಲೈನ್, ರೆಸಿನ್ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೆಸಿನ್ ಫೀಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. And also it is used in the aerospace, marine applications, carbon fiber, epoxy. It is one of the materials, aircraft tiling edges is used, and e-glass, it is used for the epoxy, with epoxy materials in the boating system. Carbon fiber with PVC epoxy, it is used in this automotive and other applications. And also resin transfer molding applications, it is used in the vehicle bonnet and also some of the major portions of the vehicle doors. And Tesla company is also using almost all these applications. The one of the very advantages of this one, any vehicles is fast moving, any particles are hits, the damage of the materials is low as it is almost all possible. Say existing composites applications and competing the materials in the major end use of the market. Fuselage wing control surfaces in the aerospace, it is almost all it is used in the composite materials. Aluminium, steels and plastics are the major portions of the materials is used in the fan blades, tile cones and interiors of the aerospace. And in the transportations, aluminium, steel, iron and plastic is used. Compared to aerospace, iron is not used in the aerospace. See, this transportation, it is used almost all iron it is used. and also mono QQ and chassis and body closures under the body, interiors, front cabin, trunk is used in the transportation industries. And in the wind energy, wind blades and also spinners, steel and iron is used in the wind energy. And in the constructions, the bathtub doors and windows, roofing and cladding, and swimming pools, concrete, steels, and almost all plastic materials are used in the construction. Then if you go to the marine, say aluminium, wood, and steel plastics are used, hull, decks, fly bridges, radomes, and mast, radars, and center boards is using the, using these are the existing composites applications, comparing the materials in the major end use in the market materials. Say carbon and glass materials, it is used almost till entire body of the materials is made up of a glass fibers. And in the vehicle truck, front bumper, it is made up of a carbon fiber. So engineering applications in the helmets is used in the composite polymer matrix composites materials, and also in the electrical applications, wind turbine blades and bearing liners, especially it is used in the composite liners. It is a red color you are observing in this bearing liners, red color is a polytetrafluoroethylene materials is used. It is high wear resistance materials, it can be used for the certain degree temperature conditions also. So composites in this carbon fibers, it is used in the chopped e-glass fibers and epoxy, it is used for the light in weight and high strength. Entire it is a chassis of the bicycles is also used in the composite materials. And composite is construction industries, tat board, well, and also it is the high terminal Saudi Arabia, fiberglass plus fluoro polymer, airplanes, weight and reliability, fatigues. It is used in the aerodrome, composite in constructions materials are used. And also AV 8B area composite wing box, it is used. A composite is used in the Boeing aircraft, is the entire composite structures, and also carbon sandwich, it is a some more light blue color. Fiberglass, it's a glass fibers is used in the green color portions, some wing to fuselage joint, and aluminium is made up of some kinds of portions. And as a Boeing 787, benefits of the 787 is the light in weight, fuel efficient, longer range, offer incorporations of the composite materials, reduce the maintenance cost, high reduction in fatigue, highly corrosion resistance, and also increase the passenger comfort, increase the cabin pressure, increase the humidity, results of a high corrosion resistance, bigger windows due to increased strength, less noise, and a decreased assembly time, parts arrive from supplier as a net shape, components are pre-installed in parts of the supplier factory. So applications of composites in aircraft, Boeing 777 and 11% composite, 70% aluminium, 7% titanium, 11% steel and 1% other. So there is a Boeing 787 is 50% of composite is increased, Boeing 77 to 787, 20%, reduce the aluminium materials up to 20%, up to 50%, and also 15% titanium, 10% steel and 5% other materials. Commercial transport aircraft, Boeing 787 and also some of the graphite materials, flight control systems, it is used in some aluminium materials, and also advanced avionics and cockpit, it is made up of the composite materials, graphite composite fin, drag chute, elevons, it is made up of the composite materials, and 7 multipurpose store stations, multi-door radar, it is made up of a composite materials in now LCA. LCA is called light combat aircraft. In India, it is indigenously designed. Composite design materials, this is the LCA, it is manufactured in HAL, our Hindustan Aeronautic Limited. So again, AV-8B Harrier is a composite wing box, ANSA FRP, it is entirely made up of, it is used for the training CRM of office community, training of aircraft. Aircraft, entire aircraft, it is used for the shooting and also training of the aircraft in NAL, National Aerospace Laboratory, Flight Experiment Division. So it is the royalty of a patent is transferred to Tanaja Aerospace in Osur. Entire manufacturing activity or R&D activity is taken National Aerospace Laboratory. That National Aerospace Laboratory, all the data, all the design data is transferred to Tanaja Aerospace and Aviation. These people, Tanaja Aerospace and Aviation is manufacturing this aircraft. So, and again, composite primary structures, graph, carbon and glass, and also one of the B2 spirit, all composites can much of the other composite materials. Use of a composites in military aircraft from 1937 to present is increased. increased composite materials. Initially it is used 2% composite, again 10%, again 24%. So increase the utilizations of the composite materials, increase the fuel efficiency, increase the life of the composite as compared to the other materials, so life of the aircraft materials, and also damage is also very less as compared to other materials. Top five areas of the composites innovations to address this market needs. One is the application development, aerospace, fuselage, wing, fan blades, etc., automotive, suspension, control arms, wheels, roof panels, etc., wind energy, tower drives, shifts, etc., low materials cost, say, and also low cycle time and high lab rate, high pressure RTM by using a resin transport molding, and also CFRTP, say, and resin transport molding for carbon fiber reinforced plastics, and also pressure press play plans composite 17 minutes, and also property enhancement of the composite will increase the mechanical performance, strength, stiffness, etc. of the glass and carbon fibers, develop the better resin systems, low cure, low gel, high strength, and composite recycling is also closed loops, carbon fiber reinforced plastic recycling technology by using a BMW for its I3 collaboration between the BMW and Boeing for a composites recycling. So this the one of the very much advantages of the composite, advanced composite materials, it is called as the automated tape laying machine used to the layup of the flight deck door. So this is the one of the latest technology generally using a composite materials. One is the layer by layer vacuum assisted resin transfer molding, pultrusion materials, and also filament winding materials and resin transfer molding materials, and also pre-preg impregnated materials. Now by using a pre-preg is one of the technique, it's a pre-preg material, your automated layup is one of the advanced composite manufacturing technology, and also 3D printing it is also one of the advantages. By using a carbon fiber filament is melted by using a selective laser melting process, in the 3D printing process, the layer by layer materials is manufactured in this composite materials. Innovations in composites and its applications, light in weight, cost reductions, and also before this, I will show one small video about the layer by layer composites, how it is manufactured. Hello, dear participant, shall I show one small video? Hello, Manjunath Babu.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sure. I will show one small video. Hello, visible sound and audio. Video. Hello,
yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So this is the automated manufacturing of a pre-impregnated resin material, pre-impregnated tape is nothing but in the company itself coated the resin, so depending upon the dimensions they are coated the resins, and by using that resin impregnated fibers manufactured by using a robotic application. There is a layer by layer instead of a manual, it is a robotic applications.
Electro impact. is comprised of about 4 to 500 engineers. We serve aerospace primarily. Our main customers are Boeing, Airbus, Embraer, Bombardier, Northrop, and Spirit. And these customers use our equipment to automate the assembly of aircraft parts. So Electro-Impact has a really long history with FANUC. In 2004, we were tasked with figuring out fire replacement. We approached more than one CNC vendor, but FANUC was the one that was most able and willing to meet our needs. At the time, there was no interpolating outputs with respect to CNC motion, and they allowed us inroad to actually code that interface in for itself. It allowed us to have a really high-level part program and allowed us to push the AFP business forward. At the time, a fast AFP machine might have been, say, 400 inches per minute. And today, we now add and cut at 3,000 inches per minute, actual laydown is 3,000 inches per minute. If you look at this AFP head, you can see we have 16 bobbin wound spools. The spools hold a half inch wide piece of carbon fiber tape. And the job is to put that tape out.
So we are participants, how the materials in the CNC machines, there is a different types of a turret. Like that in this composite, it is also having a different types of the fibers is placed in the woven on the by using a rollers. It is passed in the materials in the one side, and depending upon the stacking sequence, how they play 0 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, and plus 45 degree, 30 degree, like that. This is the different stacking sequence. Similarly, like that, different stacking sequence, like that, the different materials is also possible for the manufacturing by using this kind of a technology.
And landed on the part very accurately at extremely high speeds. We need to have very high acceleration machines, and that's one place where the FANUC system is kind of fun. The X, Y, and Z axes are 1,500 horsepower, and that's just so that we can move the machine quick enough and dynamically enough to get the job done. It's one thing to go fast, but you have to also accelerate really fast. So we accelerate this machine here at over half a G to achieve that a reasonable deceleration distance. And for really short course products like a Stringer system, we actually are offering up machines up to 1G acceleration. And you know, we obviously get it done with big FANUC motors. So this is a 6 degree of freedom machine, has 3 prismatic axes and 3 revolute axes. The primary X drive, that's the first axis in the system, is made up of 4 alpha 500s. The Z drive, we have 4 ball screws in each of the 4 corners of this column. That is 4 alpha 300s. And then we have 2 Y axis linear motors. We have 2 alpha 50 for the A axis, smaller FANUC motor for the B axis, and then a giant custom torque motor for the C axis. The C axis is pretty cool. It can spin 480 degrees a second and accelerates at 1300 degrees per second squared. We don't mess around with power on the machine. Reliability is quite important to our customers. That's our number one concern in the fiber placement industries. We really have had great success in the reliability of the FANUC side of it. It's aerospace, they want the best, and we pick the very best components we can. So if you made it onto my machine, it's the best we could find. We've had great success with their equipment. It's really reliable. And I like working with the engineers in Japan and the local engineers here in America. Without that relationship with FANUC, we probably wouldn't have been able to drive this industry forward.
This role of ColorFab CF20 has been sitting untouched.
So, dear participants, this is one of the 3D printing technology by using a carbon fiber barrier is passed through the some nozzle, and it is melted and layer by layer. So there is some carbon fiber composite materials is manufactured by using a 3D printing technology.
Now I finally found the time to put this carbon fiber material through its paces. This week, we'll be looking at print quality, mechanical strength, and temperature performance of this more exotic material, and I'll also talk about some safety concerns. Guten Tag, everybody, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. ColorFabX TCF20 comes nicely sealed on 750 grams spools that sell for 50 bucks, which gives it a price of $67 a kilogram. This filament is based on ColorFab's XC material, which is copolyester based and filled with 20% carbon fiber. The carbon is added as short fibers, which during the printing process orientate themselves in the print direction, which gives the part very unique properties, on which I'll come later. When printing this kind of filled materials, it's very important to use abrasion resistant nozzles, because otherwise the inside of your hot end will erode away in no time. I used a hardened steel 0.4 mm nozzle from E3D, which is capable of handling this task. Tungsten or ruby nozzles are also an option, but never ever print reinforced filaments with brass or stainless steel nozzles. Usually, I print my whole set of test samples and then analyze them. Unfortunately, I noticed after the first run that the printed parts showed quite a lot of porosity, probably due to moisture. So I dried the roll of filament in my oven at 65 degrees Celsius for around 6 hours and reprinted all of the material test samples, and this filament test ended up to be way more effort than I anticipated. The first thing I noticed was that instead of an extrusion factor of 100%, I now needed to increase it significantly to 130% to get good prints. I printed all of the parts as always on my original Prusa Mark IIs, where I added some magic goo on the 70 degree bed and didn't have any warping or first layer adhesion problems as soon as the first layer thickness was set correctly. I tried fan speeds between 0 and 100%, where starting at 25%, the overhanging parts of the prints looked very nice. In the end, I settled with 35% fan for the rest of the samples. I tried nozzle temperatures between 230 and 270 degrees Celsius, which all of them worked fine, though 250 degrees looked the best and had proper layer adhesion, so this was the temperature I used for the rest of the samples. Since the material is a copolyester, I had some issues with bits of material sticking to the nozzle and the heat block, which let loose from time to time and ended up on my parts. Overhangs printed great up to 65 degrees, and boy, look at these outer surfaces. The matte look gives these parts a finish I haven't seen so far with any other material. The material doesn't string, but left some nasty material blobs at the stringing tests, though fine details came out well. Playing around with retraction settings and using dried material would probably increase the quality. Bridging was strange, because at first the part looked really awful. Out of curiosity, I used Slicer Prusa Edition instead of Simplify 3D, which made such a difference. Almost perfect bridging, even at the largest gap. I tried to tune the settings in Simplify 3D, but nothing I did improved the print quality, which is really strange. The 3D Banshee reflects these results because it showed the blobs at the retraction points and some material bits at a couple of places. Still, if you overlook these, then the rest of the board looks stunning with the matte black finish. Let's now take a look at the material properties of ColorFab XT CF20. The tensile strength of around 45 megapascals before drying it wasn't very impressive, and even lower than regular, unfilled PETG. After drying the material, it improved more than 20% and ended up with 55 megapascals, which is better but still below regular PLA. Layer adhesion was only okay, and the specimens printed standing failed at 18 megapascals, which is only one third of the strength of the lying specimens. The tensile modulus, so the stiffness of the material, is what really stands out, because with almost 3000 megapascals, it is the most rigid material I printed so far. This is the first time when I also tested the stiffness perpendicular to the printing direction, so the upright specimens. If we take a look at a microscope shot of the material, we see that the carbon fibers orientate themselves in the printing direction, and these fibers give the material its superb rigidity. Perpendicular to the printing direction, they are only barely adding strength and stiffness, which is verified by my second test that showed a tensile modulus of only 1100 megapascals in this direction. So keep this in mind with your designs. If you use fiber-reinforced materials, they have very different properties in and perpendicular to the printing direction. The filament test also confirmed the superior stiffness of this material, even in comparison to PLA. The slope at the beginning of the test indicates the modulus. The steeper it is, the more rigid the material is. My test hooks fail at around 50 kilograms of load, which is in the mid-range. The standing one only was able to bear 16 kilograms until failure, which confirms the previous tests. Temperature resistance was good, and the material stayed rigid up to 80 degrees, and then totally failed at 85 degrees Celsius. The impact strength was okay, and an improvement over regular PETG or PLA, but far away from the toughness of, for example, polycarbonate. I've been mentioning safety concerns in the beginning. This material is filled with lots of very tiny fibers, which might come loose during printing, cleaning, or reworking. I wasn't really feeling comfortable printing XTCF20 in my office, and when reworking this material, which, by the way, works very well, a respirator is definitely a must. I don't know if I'm overcautious, but I have a bad feeling having these particles in my office. What do you guys think? All in all, it was very interesting for me to work with Colorfab's XTCF20. It requires some special setup due to the special nozzles needed, but delivers stunning looking parts. Overall, strength was only okay, but the stiffness of the material is really standing out. If you need a material that is stiffer than most other materials, this is definitely not a bad choice. If you require only strength and toughness, there are other materials around that might be more suitable. You can find links to the material and the test methods I use down in the description. The detailed test report, together with the printing profile and all of the test samples, are available for my Patreons. If you enjoyed this video and learned something, then hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more. If you have suggestions and comments about my methods, please leave them down below and let me know what other materials you would like to see me invest in.
So, hello, dear participants. So there is an innovation in composite applications. Light weighting on cost reductions are the two mega trends in various applications. So application segments such as automotive, aerospace, and wind energy. In automotive industries, low-cost carbon fibers, composite parts for different applications are emerging. Government regulations on fuel efficient are putting pressure on OEMs to make their vehicle lighter. So new one-piece CFRP wheels, it's manufacturing BMW i3 carbon fiber recycled roofs. And also in aerospace, increasing the usage of carbon composites and nanocomposites applications are emerging. Aerospace industry is moving towards automated tape laying and automated fiber placement process to increase the increase throughput. So just now you are seeing that's the automated tape lay and automated composite by using a robotics technology. These are all the two mega segments of the manufacturing of automated fiber placements, automated lay system. So in the wind energy, there is a growing trend towards the developing one piece and modular wind blades technology. Carbon fiber fuselage usage is also growing in line with the increase in blade length greater than 50 meters. Say Boeing 737 maximum, new modular wind blades, and say new glass growing for LFT. Monolithic design of the Siemens B75 world's largest fiber glass component cast in one piece setup. Say if you have any free time, please you visit the Baspete wind turbine blades manufacturing company along with your students or any research scholars. So you're getting the good idea about the composite manufacturing, how the system is working to manufacturing towards manufacturing of wind turbine blades. So emerging use of a 3D printing, just now you are observed 3D printing with a composite manufacturing, say a model for a mix of a carbon fiber and a plastics, ABS, acrylo, butyl, styrene, rubber type of materials. It opens the door for a mass production of automotive parts car with 3D printing. Say local motors and Thermwood has developed first 3D printed car named called Strati. This car takes 44 hours print, 1 day to mill and 2 days to assemble, making a 5 days build process in total. The Strati is printed by stacking down layer upon layer of a combination of about 80% ABS plastics and 20% carbon fiber reinforcement. It takes about 212 layers of these materials to complete the status chassis. It is the first time that the main portions of the car has been printed in one piece using a direct digital manufacturing system is involved in the 3D printing of the automotive parts. Say parts consolidation, one piece mono cube systems, Adventador, say RTM resin transfer molding, Lambo technology, and heraldite epoxy and dry stitching fiber faster, one shot forged composite technology, vinyl ester resins, 1 to 2 inch long cut 12K carbon fibers, and also say car weight is 3,417 pounds lighter than 2,202. Pounds is lighter as compared to 3,472. So by using a carbon fiber reinforcement, by weight is almost all reduced 50% is a one piece of carbon fiber. So this is the one of the beauty and the technique of the composite materials, the advanced the composite materials is manufacturing. Megatrends in composite industry innovations, lighter in weight of automotive, aerospace and industrial parts, enhanced mechanical, chemical and conductive properties of fiber and resin system, incorporations of a nanotechnology in next generations of the composites, cost reductions of composite parts, role of additive manufacturing and robotics, faster and more predictable infusion, reductions in number of parts counts in many applications, and also environmental friendly resins and fiber system. Composites are under represented in many markets and potential application. The above innovation trends will enable composite materials to increase the penetrations across different industries such as automotive, aerospace and wind turbines. So the nanocomposites is one of the major roles in composite manufacturing industry. Nano particulates introduced into macroscopic sample materials, percentage by weight of the nanoparticulates can remain very low, on the order of 0.5 to 5%. Nanocomposites may exhibit enhanced property, electrical and thermal conductivity, optical properties, dielectric properties, mechanical properties, or nanoparticles can impart new physical properties and behaviors to matrix. So genuine nanocomposites are hybrids, flame retardancy, accelerated biodegradability materials is very, very important. So this biodegradability, you are going to producing a natural composite materials, the nanocomposites under a microscope, polymer matrix and carbon nanotubes is one of the very important techniques. From the 2000 to 2010, as wind energy is increased, aerospace, automotive and composite consumption, future growth, civil engineering, oil and gas and medical engineering, automotive to civil engineering, oil and gas and medical market expected to be a key future growth engineers for composites and innovations in the 2025 to 2035 in the major in the medical applications of the composite materials.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Sir, please, any
questions? I request the participants. Aside, if any queries is there, you can post it in the chat box or you can
ask questions directly, no problem. Please feel to ask
participants. If any queries is there, you can please ask the question so that it may be helpful for you to carry out the research in future. Any queries from the participants, please? Sir, I have one question.
Yeah, please.
The different fibers available, available. So I have noticed that the Kevlar fiber.
Yes, sir.
Is a very difficult to machine, sir. Why it is there? Which property makes it too difficult, sir?
So this is the aromatic hydrocarbon, sir. Compared to carbon fiber, compared to glass fiber, the material is very harder. Very harder. See, this is the glass you can possible to machine, and carbon fiber it is also possible to machine. But in this present, still we doesn't know the what is the chemical composition, chemical structure of Kevlar fiber. This is not released, sir. This materials is the no one it is manufactured. These materials, these materials in the any paper, so you can't possible for find out the what is the materials behind it. So if you go to the carbon fiber, if you go to the glass fiber, any manufacturer is a manufacturer in India. There is a limited manufacturing company. This is a totally patent is there in this materials. We still we can't possible for estimate the what is the what is this materials, what is this materials, what is the Kevlar materials, what is the aramid materials. We don't know, sir. We don't know, really. We don't know about this this materials. If you go to the deep depth of carbon paper, we can possible for getting the information. Go to the this one, what is that, glass fibers and any other fiber, boron fiber and all those things, but especially this aramid fiber, we don't know, sir. We are not getting the information.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you. So any queries from participants end? Okay, sir. I think we can close this session,
okay,
sir. And Dr. Mohan sir has posted his email ID. If any
yes,
queries regarding regarding the research, so you can contact Mohan sir through his mail. Sir will communicate to you people through mail, and
okay,
he will answer you people through mail. Okay, on behalf of our management principal, vice principal, dean and all our staffs, and also the participants, I would like to thank Dr. Mohan sir for accepting our invitation at the earliest, and also sharing your views, sharing your knowledge to all the research communities. So thank you, sir. Thank you,
sir. Thank you, head of the professor and head department of mechanical engineering, Dr. Timmayya Institute of Technology, and coordinators, and also all the participants. And my special thanks to Dr. Manjunath Babu for a given opportunity for sharing my knowledge to your college faculties, research scholars, and students, and also participants. So once again, thank you for one and all, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. And the participants, I will post you the feedback link so in the chat box, so you can just fill the feedback form. So hardly 3 minutes time will be given.